Okay, what is up there, YouTube? This is J-Man Time, and today I have another World War II tank and armored vehicle video for you. And in this video, we're going to go over the rare Lithuanian tanks and armored fighting vehicles of the Second World War, 1939 through 1940. Now, I know what you're thinking. World War II didn't end until 1945. Yes, but Lithuania was technically annexed by the Soviet Union in 1940 during the second year of World War II, so Lithuania was only involved in the conflict for about a year. Lithuania in the Second World War had a very small army. The Lithuanian army had just 30,000 troops, had 48 tanks, and 12 armored fighting vehicles, armored cars, and armored trucks, flying smaller armies on the Eastern Front during the early days of the war. Keep in mind, Lithuania in the years before World War II had a lot of tension with its neighbors, mostly Germany, Poland, and the Soviet Union. For one, the Germans wanted control of Lithuania's Memel region, which Lithuania actually gave to Germany in 1939, just before the start of World War II. Lithuania also had beef with Poland over the Vilnius region. Vilnius was part of Lithuania before the Polish-Lithuanian War of 1919, but was later taken by Poland at the end of that conflict. So by the late 1930s, the Lithuanians were basically asking the Poles to hand back Vilnius, and Vilnius is considered the capital of Lithuania then, and is now the capital of Lithuania today in the modern era. On top of that, the Lithuanians had to deal with the Soviet Union. Now, Lithuania tried to be neutral with all three countries, but they were all pushing Lithuania to side with one of them. For example, Germany wanted Lithuania to join the Axis powers in the upcoming invasion of Poland in September of 1939. The Soviet Union also wanted Lithuania to join their side. And then you had Poland, which was a very strange relationship, as Poland wanted Lithuania to remain independent or neutral towards Poland in case of a German invasion of Poland, which came in September of 1939. So, Lithuania spent pretty much the last 2 years before World War II trying to rearm. In fact, they had managed to get some 48 tanks and a small number of armored cars just before the war, along with a number of infantry weapons. But this wasn't enough, and later on in 1940, the Soviet Union requested that Lithuania allow its troops to enter the Lithuanian territory in order to protect Lithuania as a protectorate. Now, Lithuania wasn't the only country the Soviets would enter. They would also enter Latvia and Estonia as well, and were technically annexed by the Soviet Union until 1941. In 1941, Germany invaded the Soviet Union during Operation Barbarossa and technically freed the Lithuanians, at least they thought at first, but then the Germans took control of Lithuania also, creating a pro-German government in 1941-1942. And then Lithuania was captured by the Soviet Union again in 1944-1945 at the end of World War II. Now let's go over Lithuania's tanks and armored fighting vehicles. Lithuania had just 48 tanks and 12 armored cars. A huge chunk of Lithuania's armor was all the World War I vintage tanks and armored fighting vehicles. Now, at the very end of World War I, Lithuania was freed from the Russian Empire, as the Russian Empire collapsed into civil war, and the area known as Lithuania had already been captured by German and Austro-Hungarian troops. So Lithuania declared independence. But later in 1918-1919, the Soviets came, and this began the Lithuanian War of Independence, or the anti-Soviet war in Lithuania. Later on in 1919, there was another war between Lithuania and Poland, known as the Polish-Lithuanian War, in which Poland took over the Lithuanian capital of Vilnius. During this part of the war, the Lithuanians did manage to get some armored fighting vehicles. This was the start of Lithuania having armored fighting vehicles. We're going to start with tanks first, and the first tank on the list is the French Renault FT-17. Now, Lithuania received 12 FT-17s in 1923, and these were the first tanks used in the Lithuanian army, and they were still in service in the Lithuanian army when the Soviets annexed the country in 1940. The FT-17 is a French light tank from 1917. Its main armament was either one 30 caliber machine gun. In the case of Lithuania, it was 1.303 caliber British Maxim machine gun, or one 37mm SA-18 main gun. The armor thickness was only 8 to 22mm, and the vehicle had a speed of 7 kilometers an hour or 4.3 miles per hour. The tank had a crew of 2, and as I mentioned, Lithuania received 12 of these tanks in 1923, and these were Lithuania's first tanks to serve in the Lithuanian army. Now, these vehicles were still in service as mostly rearguard and training vehicles in 1939-1940. Now, in September of 1939, Germany invaded Poland. Later on September the 17th, the Soviet Union invaded Poland also. During the Soviet invasion of Poland, the Soviet Union handed over the city of Vilnius to Lithuania. So Lithuanian troops, along with their armored fighting vehicles, entered the city, including some of these FT-17s, which were acting as rearguard vehicles and policing vehicles, both in Lithuania and in Vilnius as a whole. Later on, in 1940, the Soviet Union would annex Lithuania in 1940, and Lithuania was invaded in 1941 by Germany as part of Operation Barbarossa. During Operation Barbarossa, these old FT-17s were brought out by the Soviet forces and Soviet Lithuanian forces, and they were used against the German forces during the invasion of Lithuania and the Soviet Union. Most of these vehicles were probably destroyed, but the remaining vehicles were captured by the Germans and were used as policing vehicles until Germany eventually surrendered at the end of World War II. After the war, the remaining FT-17s in Lithuania were scrapped by the Soviet forces, as Lithuania had been incorporated into the Soviet Union until the year 1991-1992. So these FT-17s were the first armored fighting vehicles, the first tanks adopted by the Lithuanians in 1923, and they were used at the very start of World War II, and they were still being used as policing vehicles by the occupying Germans at the end of the war. The next tanks that Lithuania managed to get their hands on just before World War II were British-made Vickers Carden Lloyd Model 1933 light amphibious tanks. These tanks were developed between 1932 and 1933, and Lithuania managed to purchase 18 of the Model 1933 variant, and these became Lithuania's first amphibious light tanks. The main armament was 1.303 caliber machine gun, and the armor thickness was just 11 millimeters. The speed of the vehicle was 43 kilometers per hour or 27 miles per hour, and it had a crew of 2. Now, if you look at Lithuanian footage from when Lithuanian troops entered Vilnius in 1939 following the fall of Poland, you will see these tanks being used as frontline tanks. These were the first tanks to go into Vilnius following the reintegration of Vilnius into Lithuania as part of a secret agreement between the Soviet Union and Lithuania at the end of the Polish campaign in 1939. Later on, when the Germans invaded Lithuania in 1941, when it was part of the Soviet Union, these tanks were used by Soviet forces and Soviet Lithuanian troops to fight the invading German forces. Some of them were destroyed, but most of them were captured and used by the German forces during the remainder of World War II on the Eastern Front, until the Germans eventually were defeated in Lithuania in 1944-1945. After World War II, these vehicles were also scrapped for the most part, but there is at least one or two of these vehicles still surviving in Russia in the Kubinka Tank Museum, and these are some of the last surviving Carden Lloyd Model 1933 light tanks still in existence. In 1936, Lithuania also purchased another 18 Carden Lloyd light amphibious tanks, this time the Model 1936. The Model 1936 was a slight upgrade to the Model 1933. Overall, it was basically the same vehicle in design, but it had some new weapon systems. For example, some of these were fitted with 37mm Bofors anti-tank guns, and these were Swedish-made 37mm guns that were purchased by Lithuania in the mid-1930s and used as the main armament on some of these Model 1936 light amphibious tanks. The armor and speed is pretty much the same as the Model 1933, so is the crew capacity, and Lithuania had purchased some 18 of the Model 1936, including at least a handful of modified versions from Britain in the year 1936, and they were used alongside the Model 1933 tanks when Lithuania had reincorporated Vilnius in 1939, and they were also used again during the German invasion of the Soviet Union and Lithuania in 1941, by Soviet and Soviet-Lithuanian troops, some were destroyed again, and some were captured by the Germans and later used by the German occupation forces in Lithuania until the end of World War II. The 37mm version being pretty much the most powerful Lithuanian tank used in the early days of World War II and by German forces during the occupation towards the middle and end of World War II. And that brings me back to the beginning of the video. Now, at the start of this video, I mentioned that Lithuania had gained its first armored fighting vehicles during the War of Independence in 1918 and during the Polish-Lithuanian War and the Polish-Soviet War of 1918 through 1921. And that brings me back to the first vehicles on the list. Now, during the Lithuanian War of Independence, there were still German troops in Lithuania. These were German troops from the German Empire, which had just been defeated at the end of World War I. These German troops brought their own armored fighting vehicles with them, and they also handed some of these vehicles off to the newly formed Lithuanian Army in 1918 and 1919. And that brings me to the first armored car that was used by Lithuanian forces in the years after World War I, and these vehicles were still in service by World War II. And these are the German Erhard Daimler Behelfswagen EV4. The EV4, or the Behelfswagen EV4, were upgraded versions of the Erhard EV4 armored car. The Erhard armored car was the most common German armored car in the First World War. Germany had manufactured some 43 of those vehicles by the end of the conflict. In 1917-1918, they came up with another version known as the Behelfswagen. And the Behelfswagen was made using Daimler lorries instead of Daimler automobiles or cars. These were slightly larger versions, and had a different structural design than the standard Erhard armored cars from the early part of World War I. The main armament was four German-made 7.92mm Maxim machine guns. The armor thickness was 9mm. The vehicle had a speed of 61.3 kilometers per hour, or 38 miles per hour, and had a crew of between 8 and 9. Now, these vehicles were handed to Lithuania in the year 1918 and 1919. The Germans gave the newly formed Lithuanian army five of these heavy armored cars, and they became the first armored fighting vehicles used by the Lithuanians during the Lithuanian War against the Soviet Union at the time in 1918 through 1920, and against Poland in 1919 through 1920. These vehicles were still in service when the Soviets annexed Lithuania in 1940 and were still in service again as policing vehicles by the Soviet forces in Lithuania when the Germans invaded in 1941. The Germans actually took at least two of these vehicles and continued using them as occupation vehicles or policing vehicles until Germany was eventually defeated in 1944, 1945 in Lithuania. So these are some of the oldest armored cars or armored fighting vehicles that were still being used in World War II. In fact, I should do a video on that. Top 5 oldest armored fighting vehicles in World War II, and this vehicle would be on the list. And that brings me to another World War I vintage vehicle that was still being used by Lithuania in the early days of World War II. And that is one of Lithuania's second armored car, the Russian-made Fiat Izorsky, also known as the Zaibas. This was a Russian armored car that was manufactured in 1917, and it was based on a British-Italian armored car that the Imperial Russian forces had purchased in 1915 and 1916. The main armament was two 7.62mm Russian Maxim machine guns. The armor thickness was 4 to 8mm, and the vehicle had a speed of 70 kilometers per hour or 40 miles per hour, and it had a crew of at least 3 to 5 or 4 to 5. Now, Lithuania had managed to capture one of these vehicles from the Soviet forces between 1918 and 1919. They only captured one, and these were still being used by the Soviet Red Army as they were inherited from the Imperial Russian Army following its collapse at the end of World War I. After World War I, the Lithuanians continued using this vehicle during the Polish-Lithuanian War and continued using this vehicle against the remaining Soviet forces in Lithuania. Afterwards, the vehicle was used as a policing vehicle in the region of Memel, near the German border. Later on, in 1939, Germany would annex the Memel region, and this vehicle was actually taken over by the Germans. It was still being used as a policing vehicle all the way up until 1939. Later on, after the annexation of Memel, this vehicle here was incorporated into the German police in that region. Military police in that region, and was still being used by the Germans when the Soviets came back to that region in 1944-1945. It is unknown what happened to this vehicle afterwards, if it was destroyed in combat or captured by the Soviets, but it pretty much disappeared after 1944. But this vehicle here, the Fiat Izorsky, also known in Lithuania as the Zybis, was one, if not one of the oldest fighting vehicles still in service during the Second World War. And that brings me to Lithuania's most modern armored car. And this vehicle came from Sweden. Now, in the mid-1930s, the Lithuanians were trying to modernize their armored car fleet. So they went to Sweden. And they went to the Swedish Landsverk company. Now, Landsverk was known for manufacturing armored cars and tanks for both the Swedish and Norwegian armed forces. So the Lithuanians purchased 6 of a rare experimental vehicle manufactured by Landsverk, known as the Landsverk L-181. The L-181 was a medium-heavy armored car from 1935. Its main armament was 120mm Oerlikon dual-purpose anti-tank and anti-aircraft autocannon. It also had 2 7.62mm machine guns, or 7.92mm machine guns. The armor thickness was between 5 and 15mm, and the vehicle had a speed of 80 kilometers per hour, or 50 miles per hour. It had a crew of 4 to 5, and Lithuania purchased 6 of these vehicles in 1935. These were the most powerful Lithuanian armored cars at the beginning of World War II. They are sometimes seen in propaganda footage during the Lithuanian reincorporation of the city of Vilnius in 1939, following the fall of Poland. Later on, they were used by Soviet and Soviet-Lithuanian forces during the German invasion of the Soviet Union and Lithuania, and the ones that survived were later captured by the Germans and incorporated into the German occupation forces in Lithuania until the end of World War II. And that's basically it. These were all of the Lithuanian tanks and armored fighting vehicles that I could find from Lithuanian history. And these were the most powerful vehicles, in the case of tanks and armored cars, that the Lithuanians had access to at the very beginning of the Second World War. If I had to pick my 2 favorite, I would say the Vickers Carden Lloyd Model 1936, and of course the Landsverk L-181 would be my favorite, as those are clearly the most modern vehicles that Lithuania had at the start of World War II. So what do you all think of this? Please tell me in the comments section below. And until next time, this was J-Man Time, signing off. Thank you.